This is Petrinet's introduction part 3, and in this presentation we are going to start with the mutual exclusion. So this is a structure which is it represents or models the mutual exclusion. It means that when we got this P3 with a token, we cannot fire T1 and T2 at the same time. So we got here a network with conflict. It means that if you fire T1, this token leaves P3 and is added to P1. And in this position, so we cannot fire T2 or T1 again before T3 is fired. When T3 is fired, this token leaves P1 and it is added again to P3. And in this case, we can then fire T1 or T2. So this is a mutual exclusion network. Another concept is the inhibitor arc. How does the validation of a transition with an inhibitor arc works? The inhibitor arc is represented with this this ending here with the circle. So it works differently. So it means that when we got a token here, we are inhibiting transition 1 to be fired. Okay? So only when we don't have a token in P2 is that and we have a token in P1 in this case, is that we can say that T1 is validated. So this is the case in this example here, because we have a token in P1 and we don't have a token in P2, so this means that transition 1 is validated. So if it is validated, it can be fired. And to be fired, it means that we are going to take this token from P1, we are going to add one token in P3, and okay, and P2, it doesn't happen nothing. Okay, so it stays the same. So this is the firing of a transition with an inhibitor arc. So we are going to see an example here, which is adapted from René Hassan book. We can see here that we got a part J entering a buffer key, and from buffer key, the parts are going to enter a machine M. In this case, we are going to consider that they are the machine, we are going to enter a number of parts, a batch of parts, and then the machine is working, is going to operate that batch of parts. So a Petrinet who can model this manufacturing system is this one, and I'm going to explain it step by step. So for instance, if you this transition here enables the and with this place P1, so this place P1 enables that the parts J enter the buffer key one by one. So if, for instance, I fire three times T1, so if I have T1, T1, and T1, this sequence, it means that I'm going to have 1, 2, 3 parts in P2. So if now I want to stop parts entering the buffer, so this is the buffer key, I can fire T5. If I fire T5, this token leaves P1 and is added to P4. Now I got a situation that I cannot fire T1 again, because P1 is not enabling T1. Okay, so now I have to process or assemble the parts. And so we are assuming that P3 is modeling the machine M. And so we got here three inhibitor arcs. That means that we cannot start entering parts again before we process these three parts, okay, because we got these inhibitor arcs, okay. So first we have to fire T2. We can fire T2 because P3 is empty. So firing T2, it means that we take this token from P2 and we add one token to P3. But now we cannot fire again T2 before T3 is fired. When T3 is fired, it means that the machine has just processed one part, and so the part leaves the machine and is ready again to take another part. So I can then fire again T2, take this token, deposit another or add another token here, and do it again. When the machine processes the part, I fire T3, and this leaves the system. So now, still, I cannot open the entrance to another part, because I still have one part here waiting to be processed from the batch. And so I have to fire again T2 to add the token here. And now, when T3 is fired, it means that now I have no parts waiting to be processed, no part in the machine, so I can, so this is inhibitor work, arc is not working, and also this, so I can fire again T4. So if I fire T4, which I can do now because this is empty and this is empty again, this token leaves P4 and is added again to P1. So now I can also again enter parts in buffer key. Okay, so this is, it was done for a batch of 3 parts, but you can do it with another number. So this is the example that I told you with 3 parts, and then this is the simulation of in this case, this bottleneck means that the last part is being processed in the machine. So these, I don't have parts waiting to be processed, but still I have one here, which is inhibiting the firing of T4. This example 2 is another example with where I got a car that is in initial position A. When I press P1, I'm going to activate the motor M1, so the car is going to travel this way until this position. And when it reaches this position, it's going to unload the car, the components in another car, C2, which is in its initial position. C2 then has to travel to unload in this position C and return again to position B. Car 2 is commanded by P2 and car 1 by P1. We are going to consider that the load and unload is instantaneously. And so the question is how to model this system with a BattleNet. Again, I'm going to provide a solution. And the solution is this one. So we got place P1 models the car in the initial position, in the position A, car 1, and place P4, car 2 in position B. Then, making sure that we got the car in the initial position, sensor A is true. If I press P1, I'm going to fire this transition T1, and this token is headed to P2. P2 means that I'm going to activate motor M1. So motor M1 is going to be activated until the car reaches this position here. Okay. It means that this C1 in B is going to be true. And then I'm going to fire T2. This token then moves to P3. And okay, it means that the car is waiting now to unload. Car 1 is waiting to unload in car C2. But so car C2 is in a position, so I can fire T3. It means that I'm going to redraw this token and this one. I'm going to add a token in P6 and another in P5. So the meaning of the network now is that car C2 is traveling at waiting M2. I got P5. P5 means that the motor of car 1 is activated until it reaches again the position until it makes this journey, and then it reaches the initial position, so I can fire a T5 and I have the car in the C1 in the initial position. So car C2 is traveling and it reaches the position C. This transition is fired and I got a token in P7 again. So this is the unload, and then I have to wait the car until it reaches the position C2B. And then I got the token in P4, and this is the initial position again. So this is a kind of cycle, and hopefully this was not too hard. And I conclude just with the references from René David and Hassan Ala book, and also this UTID series. Okay, thank you.